Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Jai Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki Okay, I can begin.
I'm audible?
Yes. I can hear you.
Is it clear?
Yes.
Yeah. So we are trying to get your voice here. Just a second, Maharaj. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Manan, can you try to speak?
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Not yet, Maharaj. We'll try one more time, please.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Yeah, I can hear you, Maharaj. I can hear you, and the audience who are on the Zoom, they can hear you, but the people, the devotee from here in the temple, they couldn't hear. So we are trying for that. Sorry, Maharaj.
Hello. त्यो ल्यापटपबाट जो आवाज आउट आउटको एउटा उद्यो हुन्छ नि हो त्योबाट निकालेर तपाईँको जो साउन्ड बक्स छ नि त्यहाँ इन गरिदिनु
हाम्रो प्रोजेक्टरमा पनि छ यो प्रोजेक्टरमा
हजुर जुनमा पनि नि जो अडियो इन हुन्छ नि इन गरिदिनु त्यहाँ हुन्छ अनि तपाईँले भिन्न अर्को फोनबाट नाचा लगाएर ट्रान्सलेट गर्नुहोस् तपाईँ अझै एउटामा पाउनु हुन्छ हजुर ल्यापटपको अडियो आउटबाट तपाईँको त्यो साउन्ड बक्समा अडियो इन गर्नुहोस्
हरे
कृष्ण
ल्यापटपको अडियो आउट
गर्नुहोस् हरिबल परुजी सजिलो एउटा भनिदिन्छु हरिबल परुजी हरे कृष्ण तपाईँसँग एचडिएमआईको रसिद छ नि होइन हो त ल्यापटपबाट प्रोजेक्टरमा इन गरिदिनु त अडियो पनि भिडियो पनि अटो इन हुन्छ
एकैछिन ल प्रभु हामी यहाँ अर्को तरिका
प्रोजेक्टरमा कसरी भिडियो अट गर्नुभयो
प्रोजेक्टरमा यो कम्प्युटरदेखि के हो ब्रो मलाई त त्यति हरे कृष्ण महाराज होइन हरे कृष्ण
हरे कृष्ण
यस महाराज नाउ वी कैन
So I can begin?
Yes, Maharaj, you can begin.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chaksurun Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namane Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pricharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha kripa sindhu bhayavacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavibhyo namo namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram 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 Hare Hare So I would like to begin by wishing everyone very happy New Year. So we hope 2021 will be a happy year for us. Let's hope it will be an improvement on the previous year where we had so many problems. Of course, last year we installed Lord Jagannath, and we had a nice festival there to begin the worship of Lord Jagannath. We did not think, nobody thought that this whole year could be the way it has been, with so much disease and so many dangers. So your material life has certainly been affected. But these material problems are an impetus to our spiritual life, that we can do better, we can have more time for our spiritual practice. There will always be problems in the material world, and the solution to all of the problems is simply Krishna consciousness. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, Narada Muni was instructing Srila Vyasadeva, and he told him the problems. Anarto pasamam shakshad bhakti yoga adhoksaje. The material miseries can be all finished by the process of bhakti yoga. So Lord Jagannath has kindly come there to Kosamoy along with his brother Balaram and his sister Subhadra, and they're so kindly there with you in Kosamoy to inspire you in your bhakti yoga. Lord Jagannath is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Sri Krishna. And Lord Balaram, he's the older brother of Krishna in Krishna Leela, but Lord Balaram is the original spiritual master. He represents the Guru. If we want to approach Krishna, we have to go through the Guru. So Lord, we have to go to Lord Balaram to get the blessings of Lord Jagannath. We cannot go directly to Jagannath.
यदि हामीलाई भगवान चाहिन्छ, भगवान जगन्नाथ जी शान्तिकै भगवान प्राप्त गर्ने हो भने गुरु परम्पराको पद्धतिदेखि जानुपर्छ। र त्यसै कारण हामीले पहिला सुरु बलरामजीसँग गएर बल्ल जगन्नाथलाई प्राप्त गर्न सकिन्छ।
Right, we are singing every morning in our Guru Vastikam. Yasya prasada bhagavat prasado, yasya prasad nagati katopi. By the mercy of the Guru, we get the mercy of Krishna.
Just like we are doing in the Guru Vastikam, Guru ko kirpa le garera, we can get the Krishna.
So Lord Balaram is the original spiritual master, and he is very merciful to help all of us in the process of Krishna consciousness. In the Kali Yuga, Lord Balaram comes as Lord Nityananda and Lord Jagannath comes as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Lord Nityananda was very kind to the fallen souls, and he would give them Krishna consciousness. He would go everywhere preaching the message of Krishna. And Subhadra is Krishna's sister. She's actually born from the womb of Rohini. And late, of course, she was born in Mathura, and later on the family moved to Dwarka. So that girl, Subhadra, she was the favorite daughter of her father, Vasudev. Right? Who knows who was Subhadra married to? Yes, right. Arjuna came to Dwarka, he disguised himself like a sannyasi. And they thought, oh, he was a sannyasi, they were honoring him, they were giving him charity. But then when he got a chance, then he kidnapped Subhadra. Lord Balaram was upset. Lord Balaram was arranging for her marriage to Sishupal or to one of his friends. And Lord Balaram was angry that this Arjuna has cheated us. He disguised himself like a sannyasi. And Lord Krishna had to pacify Lord Balaram and say, please forgive him. He's my devotee. So Subhadra, she represents Bhakti Swarup. She is the personified form of devotional service. So when we worship Lord Jagannath, you have the Supreme Lord Krishna, you have the spiritual master in the form of Balaram, and you have devotional service there in the form of Subhadra.
Ranyaniri Maharaj ji le bahut mahatvapurna baat bataune hununcha हामीले भगवान जगन्नाथजीको सेवा गर्दाखेरि भगवानको रूपमा जगन्नाथजी हुनुहुन्छ, गुरुको रूपमा बलदेव हुनुभयो र भक्ति दिने भक्ति माताको रूपमा सुभद्रा माता हुनुहुन्छ भनेर महत्त्वपूर्ण बात बताउनु भयो।
So the worship of Lord Jagannath was very dear to our founder Acharya Srila Prabhupada, because even as a young child, he was always dreaming about going to Jagannath Puri to see the Rath Yatra. They were having one Rath Yatra in Calcutta. One family, the Mullicks family, they would put on Rath Yatra. But Prabhupada wanted to go to Jagannath Puri to see the real, the big Rath Yatra with the big chariots. And he would find out the times of the trains, and he'd find out how much it cost. But he was only very young, he had no money, so he couldn't go. Then finally, you know, when he was going to college, he graduated from college, and after his college graduation, then he made it, he was able to somehow get money and to go there to Puri and see the temple and have darshan. He was always thinking, either go to Puri or go to Vrindavan. And at that time, to go there, it would only cost like 4 or 5 rupees. A train would take the whole day, 24 hours to get there. Now you can go overnight. Anyway, Prabhupada went there to Puri, and he was able to see the deities and to... But then he saw also the pandas, he saw the Brahmins, he saw how, you know, they're not very strict. They do things like smoke bidis, and they eat fish sometimes. And he went to visit some friend, he had an introduction to some family friend there in Puri. He went to visit the friend and they were very nice to him and they were giving him a meal. But then when he was eating the meal, he found out there was some meat in the dish. So immediately he stopped eating.
त्यतिखेर प्रभुपादजी आफ्नो जगन्नाथपुरीमा साथीहरूमा पनि पुग्नुभएछ जानुभएछ र साथीहरूमा साथीहरूले प्रभुपादजीले स्वागत गरेछन् र प्रभुपादजीलाई प्रसाद या त भात अन्न भोजन गराउँदाखेरि मासु दिएछन् त्यतिखेर प्रभुपादजीले उत्तिखेर के गर्नुभयो म यो खान्न भनेर प्रभुपादजीले क्यान्सल गरिदिनुभयो
Prabhupada was shocked. Jagannath Puri, people are doing like this, people everywhere eating meat. And so, you know, Prabhupada, his whole life, he'd never taken any non-vegetarian food. So of course, later on, Prabhupada went to America, and when he was in San Francisco, Then one day, the devotee, Malati, the lady, she'd gone to the shop and she came back with a little Jagannath doll. And she didn't know what it was, and she showed it to Prabhupada. And when Prabhupada saw it, Prabhupada got on the floor and offered it his obeisances. She was shocked. But Prabhupada told her, he said, this is very auspicious. He said, Lord Jagannath has appeared to us. So then Prabhupada arranged, he said, go to the shop and see, get the other ones. And he found Balaram and Subhadra. And then Prabhupada had the devotee to carve them, to make big wooden Jagannath. So the devotee who knew carving, so he carved the three deities, big size, and Prabhupada said, we will put them in the temple in San Francisco, and I'll show you how to worship. So when Prabhupada showed them how to worship, they just had one big candle, and they put the one big candle on a plate, and they just held it and moved it round in a circle. And he said, yes. He said, this is how you do it. Just offer like that. And when you get tired, you give the plate to somebody else and let somebody else do it. And the deities were put on the altar, no clothes, no crown, no clothes, nothing, just the deity. They had nothing. So they just put the deity there, and Prabhupada taught them just to offer the candle, because they had no paraphernalia, they didn't know anything. So Prabhupada was just giving them, he said, you just do like this. But Prabhupada told all the people there, he said, whenever you come to the temple, you have to bring one fruit and one flower. And Prabhupada said, these things are available easily. It's not difficult for you to find a fruit and a flower. So any kind of fruit will do. It does not have to be very expensive or very big. Is that even the small fruit? But something you must bring. You should not come empty-handed.
Fruit,
Right, Krishna says, Bhagavad Gita, Patram Pushpam Palam Toyam Yome Bhaktya Prayachati Tadaham Bhakti Uparatam Ashnami Prayatatmanaha. If somebody offers to me a leaf, a flower, a fruit, or water with love and devotion, then I will accept it. So you can see how Srila Prabhupada used Lord Jagannath and the offerings to Lord Jagannath to help all the devotees there to cultivate the seed of devotion in their heart, to develop their love for Jagannath. Lord Jagannath is very merciful. He delivers the fallen souls. He gives everyone the opportunity to worship him. So Srila Prabhupada began the worship there in San Francisco, and he said from now on, he said this temple is New Jagannath Puri, because the Lord Jagannath has come here, so you can call this temple as New Jagannath Puri. So just like in sometimes you go to Jagannath Puri in India, you see, you know, it, there's a lot of shops sell alcohol there, and people come to drink alcohol and do many sinful things. But Lord Jagannath is so merciful, he can purify these sinful people. So in the same way, Lord Jagannath appeared in San Francisco for the Krishna consciousness movement. In San Francisco, there were so many young people taking drugs, and they were intoxicated and sinful in so many ways. But Lord Jagannath appeared there to deliver them, to save them.
जस्तै जगन्नाथ पुरीमा ती रक्सी बिक्री गर्नेलाई पनि जगन्नाथजीले शुद्ध बनाउनुहुन्छ त्यस्तै गरी सान फ्रान्सिस्कोमा पनि त्यस्तै बहुत थिए रक्सी खाने निसा खाने इत्यादि खाने ती सबैले त्यहाँ जगन्नाथजी प्रकट भएर सबैलाई के गराउनु भयो भक्त गराउनु भयो र शुद्ध भक्ति प्रदान गर्नुभयो
Lord Jagannath is also Patita Pavan, the deliverer of the fallen souls. He comes in that form of Lord Jagannath with big eyes to show that he knows, that he can see everything, he knows everything. And he has arms as well. He has arms to show that he is the creator, that he can create, he can produce everything. The nature of Lord Jagannath is that he reciprocates with the devotee according to the mood of the devotee. If the devotee worships him in a particular way, Lord Jagannath will reciprocate in that way.
Bhakta singa lila adan pradan karnu
Some people worship Lord Jagannath in the mood of Vrindavan. They see Lord Jagannath just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He would go to the temple in Puri and he would see Lord Jagannath in a threefold bending form, holding a flute with a peacock feather. So this is Krishna in Vrindavan. But to other people, they will worship Lord Jagannath in the mood of Vaikuntha with opulence as a great king, and they will see him with many jewels and valuable necklaces and ornaments.
र कसै कसैले जगन्नाथजीलाई वैकुण्ठाधिपति महा एकदम महाराजाको रूपमा पनि देख्दछन् वैकुण्ठमा बास गर्ने भगवान एकदम हीरा मणि हार लगाएर एकदम भैव एकदम सुखमा बसेका त्यस्तो खालको पनि कसैले मान्दछन्
There was one man, he was also going to see Lord Jagannath, but actually he was a devotee of Lord Ganesh. So his friend was telling him, come and see Lord Jagannath. Lord Jagannath, all the gods, all the devas, they all come from Lord Jagannath. So this man was a devotee of Ganesh, and he came to see Lord Jagannath, and when he saw Jagannath, he saw him as Ganesh.
जगन्नाथजीलाई त जुन रूपमा दर्शन गर्दा पनि त्यस्तै प्रकट हुनुहुन्छ भन्दाखेरि जस्तो सबै यिनी जगन्नाथी नै हुनुहुन्छ देवी देवता सबै भन्दाखेरि त्यो गणेशको भक्त र जबरजस्ती लिएर गएछ साथीले र ऊ साथीले गरेर दर्शन त्यो व्यक्तिले गरेर दर्शन गर्दाखेरि जगन्नाथजीलाई उसले के रूपमा देखेछ गणेश भगवानको रूपमा पुरा हात्तीको स्थिर भएको त्यस्तो रूपमा जगन्नाथजी प्रकट होइदिनु भएछ
जस्ट लाइक गणेश he has an elephant head with a big trunk so Lord Jagannath appeared also like that with the elephant head with a big trunk just to satisfy the desires of this man
ratto vyakti le jagannath ji ko darshan garda kheri jagannath ji ke garnu bhayo ganesh bhagwan ko jastai thakkai hatti ko tau ko bhara hastun ityadi bhara tyo rup ma prakat bhidinu bhayo cha to vyakti lai santushta garauna ko lagi bhanu ko matlab jagannath ji lai je rup ma pani hamile darshan garna sakinchha
So every year they have a special festival where Lord Jagannath will take also this dress as Ganesh the dress of Ganesh just to please the devotee of Ganesh
re esto prakar ko jagannath puri ma har sal bhagwan jagannath ji lai ganesh ko rup ma banai dinchan yani suni haru harera bhagto rup ma ganesh ko rup ma pani ek sal ma ek pal jagannath puri ma darshan garna sakinchha
we have to understand everything comes from lord krishna krishna says in the bhagavad gita अहम् सर्वस्य प्रभवो मथा सर्वं प्रवर्तते इति मद्वा भजन्ति मम बुद्ध भाव समन्विता Krishna says, I am the source of everything material and spiritual. The wise who know this will worship me with love.
रन्यानेरी हामीले के भन्नु पर्छ भन्दाखेरि भगवान् गीता भन्नुभएको छ अहम् सर्वस्य प्रभवो भन्ने श्लोकमा मद्वा सर्व प्रवर्तते संसारमा जे कुरा पनि छ जे चिज पनि छ सबै भगवान कृष्ण देखिन आउँछ कृष्णबाट नै प्रकट हुन्छ भन्ने कुरा हामीले यो चाहिँ बुझेर राख्नु पर्दछ
So all the devas, all the demigods, they all have their origin in Lord Sri Krishna. And that Lord Sri Krishna appears in the form of Lord Jagannath.
र जति पनि देवी देवताहरु छन् जति पनि 33 कोटी देवी देवता छन् सबै भगवान
Right. Lord Krishna had come there to Kurukshetra along with Balaram and Subhadra and along with many other people, all of his family, all of his wives, they'd all come there to Kurukshetra because there was a solar eclipse.
Bhagavan Krishna Kurukshetra aunu bhayeko thiyo, sath sath Balaram, Subhadra, र आफ्ना सबै मातापितालाई लिएर किनभने त्यो दिन तोला एक्लै भनेको सूर्यग्रहण चन्द्रग्रहण सूर्य चन्द्रग्रहण भएको थियो त्यसै त्यो दिनमा कुरुक्षेत्रमा आउनु भएको थियो भगवान.
So when there's solar eclipse, it's not auspicious. So as devotees, they have to do yajna at that time. They have to do sacrifice. So Lord Krishna came there to Kurukshetra, and so many sages also came. Lord Krishna engaged all the sages to do yajna, and after the yajna, he gave great charity to all of them.
सूर्य चन्द्रग्रहण भएको थियो त्यतिखेर सबै त्यहाँ आएर कुरुक्षेत्रमा आएर यज्ञ गरेका थिए. ब्राह्मणहरूले ब्राह्मण मन्त्र उच्चारण गरेर दान दक्षिणाहरू इत्यादि दिइरहेका थिए. त्यतिखेर हो त्यहाँ पनि हो त्यो कार्यक्रममा भगवान् कृष्ण पनि आइपुग्नु भएको थियो.
Now the gopis had also come from Vrindavan to Kurukshetra at that time because Krishna had sent a letter to Vrindavan to tell them all to come to Kurukshetra, that I want to see all of you. You please come to Kurukshetra and be with me there. Yeah, Krishna told the cowherd boys, you don't need to come. He said, you stay there, take care of the cows. He said, because you got your turn, you got to go to Mathura. When I went to Mathura for the wrestling match, at that time you came there to Mathura. So now you have to stay there, and the gopis, it's their turn to come to Kurukshetra. So Kurukshetra is a very special place. It's the only place outside of Vrindavan where Radha and Krishna were together. And Kurukshetra is famous for two things. Of course, one is the speaking of the Bhagavad Gita, and the other thing it's famous for is Rath Yatra.
Kurukshetra dham duita kura ko lagi vishesh prasiddha cha. Euta chai ke ho ta bhandakheri Bhagwan le Gita boleko thau ho, ra arko ke ho ta bhandakheri Kurukshetra Rath Yatra ko barema dherai prasiddha cha.
The first Rath Yatra took place there at Kurukshetra. When the gopis all came there and they saw Krishna at Kurukshetra, they were not very happy. They thought, this Krishna, he's not the same as before. We don't like this Krishna so much. Because in Vrindavan, the gopis knew Krishna as the cowherd boy with the flute and the peacock feather and his body covered with red dye from the stones of Govardhan Hill, and dressed in forest flowers, a garland of forest flowers. But now Krishna's come from Dwarka and he's very different. Just like sometimes young men, they will go from Burma and they will go to Bangkok, and after time then they come back from Bangkok back to Burma, and you know the young girls in Burma will say, oh, he looks so different, oh, he's changed so much.
कोही कोही बेला हामी थाई बर्मादेखि थाई आउँछौँ, थाई आएर यहाँ काम गरेर एकदम अलिकति कमाएर चट्टा भएर बर्मा जाँदाखेरि बर्माकाले के भन्छ, ए यो त अर्कै भएर आएछ, कृष्ण पनि द्वारिका पुगेर त्यस्तै भएको रहेछन्
भन्नुहोस्। They thought this Krishna coming from Dwarka, he's got all of his wives and he's now he's a prince and he's dressed in all the nice silk and different cloths and, you know, jewels. It's a very different Krishna. And they thought also this place Kurukshetra, this is not a very nice place here at Kurukshetra. There's so many soldiers here, all the time there's noisy chariots going back and forth, and these big elephants are going up and down. This is not a good place.
यो कुरुक्षेत्रमा मिलिटेरीहरू छन्, पुलिसहरू कुदिरहेका छन्, गाडीहरू इत्यादि जाने, र हाम्रो वृन्दावन जस्तो एकदम शान्ति खालको स्थान होइन रहेछ यो भनेर जग्गा पनि उनीहरूलाई मन पर्यो।
But if we take Krishna to Vrindavan, in Vrindavan the Yamuna River is there, the Govardhan Hill is there, in Vrindavan there's the sound of the peacocks and the parrots. Vrindavan is much nicer than this Kurukshetra. We will take Krishna to Vrindavan. So the gopis, they got Krishna and he came with Balaram and Subhadra because they all wanted to go home. They said, oh, go to Vrindavan, let's go back to Vrindavan, let's see our home, where we came from. So they were eager. So they got Krishna and Balaram and Subhadra and they brought them back to Vrindavan. So the festival of Rath Yatra is performed in the mood of bringing Krishna back to Vrindavan.
र त्यसै कारण यो रथयात्रा मनाउनुको विशेष उद्देश्य चाहिँ के हो त भन्दाखेरि गोपीहरूले भगवान कृष्णलाई कुरुक्षेत्रदेखि वृन्दावन आफ्नो घर लिएर आउनु हो त्यो भावमा कृष्णलाई तानेर जबरजस्ती वृन्दावन लिएर आउनु हो त्यो भावमा मनाउनु हो त्यो रथयात्रा हो।
Of course, Krishna never leaves Vrindavan. He's always in Vrindavan. He never leaves Vrindavan. But the difference is that sometimes he's manifest and sometimes he's not manifest. So when Krishna's not manifest, then he hides himself in the hearts of all the gopis. When Krishna is not manifest, when he is aprakat, then he hides, he's hidden in the heart of all the gopis. But the gopis coming to Kurukshetra and they saw Krishna, they thought, let's take him now, we'll take him back with us to Vrindavan. So this was the Rath Yatra. So the same way they bring Lord Chaitanya, would take part in Rath Yatra every year, and they would bring the Jagannath deities out of the main temple, and then would take the deities down the road, down to the Gundicha temple.
त्यस्तै गरी यो जगन्नाथ रथयात्रामा चैतन्य महाप्रभु भाग लिनुहुन्थ्यो, जगन्नाथपुरीमा जगन्नाथजीलाई ठुलो रथमा लिएर आएर त्यो ठुलो रस्तादेखि गुन्डिचा मन्दिर लिएर आइन्छ।
Right, for 1 week, the deities of Jagannath, they'll come out of the temple, they go down to Gundicha, they stay in the Gundicha temple for 1 week, So that Gundicha represents Vrindavan, Krishna going back to Vrindavan. Before Lord Jagannath comes, the day before Rath Yatra, they have to do the Gundicha Marjanam, they have to do the cleaning, because the Lord has not been there for 1 year, so they have to clean the whole temple very carefully. Lord Chaitanya would personally take part in this Gundicha Marjanam, cleaning the temple so carefully. Right, we will also like to have every year in Kosamoy, when you have Rath Yatra, the day before Rath Yatra, you have to do also Gundicha Marjanam, you have to do the cleaning of the temple. Of course, we still have to get a temple. We have to get the temple. We don't have the temple yet, but once we get the temple, then we will have all of these festivals. Cleaning the temple is cleaning the heart. And just like you clean the temple so carefully, we have to clean our heart very carefully. Within the heart, we have so many material desires and ambitions, attachments. We have to get rid of all of these things, and we have to purify the heart and just put Krishna consciousness there. So now in Kosamoy, devotees are very fortunate that Lord Jagannath has come to stay there. So they have full engagement in deity worship, the opportunity to serve the Lord directly in the form of the deity. Do not think of these deities as simply some statues. They are directly the Lord. The Lord incarnates in the form of the deity. At the request of all the devotees, the Lord personally appears in the form of the deity to accept our worship. We should understand someone who is offering the worship to the Lord, that he is the most fortunate person, that he is able to directly give service to the Supreme Lord. So, in worshipping the deity, it's very important to observe the principles of cleanliness and punctuality.
Saf-safai-purvak, vidhi-purvak, Bhagavan-ko-bigra-ko-seva-garna, bahut-jaruri-cha.
Prabhupada taught us these two principles are very important to get. If we want Krishna to accept our worship, we must be very clean internally and externally. And the worship must be done punctually, must be done regularly, the same times every day. There should be some nice schedule, and every day we have a schedule to make offerings, to offer arti. Remember, the deity is a person, so the deity can also hear. So the deity also likes to hear the pastimes of the Lord. The deity not only can eat. Sometimes we think deity is just there for offering food. We think the deity just eats. But the deity can also see, the deity can hear. We have to be very careful to always speak about Krishna and to chant the holy name. And it's important to have regular classes, to read the scriptures like Srimad Bhagavatam and let Lord Jagannath hear. So we want to develop our Krishna consciousness. We have to follow the process. It begins with hearing and chanting and then remembering. And there are nice festivals for Lord Jagannath. We have to try to observe the different festivals, not only Rath Yatra, but also Snan Yatra. That's also a nice festival. And after Snan Yatra, then Lord Jagannath gets sick, no darshan for 14 days, 15 days. At that time you have to offer special food. Just like if we are sick, we won't have the same diet, we'll have special diet. So Lord Jagannath also has to get special diet at that time. So many festivals, so many duties we have for the service of Lord Jagannath, just to keep us all Krishna conscious. We should be thinking always about the deities, how to serve and how to improve our service for the deity. The ladies can make clothes, make a new dress, new outfit for the deities. And they can make crowns and jewelry and necklaces for the deity. Not only just make flower garlands, but make so many jewelries and ornaments for the pleasure of Krishna. And if you can grow your own vegetables, that's also very nice, to grow your own vegetables, because that's love and devotion. You're showing real love and devotion for Lord Jagannath by cooking nice vegetables to offer to him. I know in Jagannath Puri, they also have their vegetables, they have their land there, they grow flowers, they grow fruits, they grow vegetables, all for the pleasure of Lord Jagannath. So we want to make another new Jagannath Puri there in Koh Samui. So we need all of your cooperation. Okay, we will stop. Ask if there's any question.
Hare Krishna Maharaj.
Hare Krishna.
Please accept my humble obeisances, our Guru Krishna Prabhupada. So mostly devotee have our own deities in their house. So what is the difference worship in home deity and the temple deities? Is the same or different?
There should not be any difference. It should be same standard to do it properly. If you're going to worship the deity at home, then you have to follow the standards just like they do in the temple. Now some people, they may, actually it's better for devotees to all do the worship in the temple, because if they all have their own deities in their home, then it means they don't go to the temple, and that's not very good. So Prabhupada liked that the devotees would all come to the temple and take part in the program there. Because if you have your own deities and you say, no, I have my own deity, I do my puja at home, means you don't come to temple, you don't hear the class, you don't take part in the program. It's not very good. And we even had the case in Vrindavan some years ago, there were many devotees, they were staying in the ashram, and they were not coming to arti. They said, no, I have my shila, I have my deity, and they were all having deities and shilas and things in their room. And they were just sitting in their room in the ashram doing their puja, and they wouldn't go to temple room, although they were living in the temple. So they stopped that. They said, no, you can't do like this. You have to come to temple program. Otherwise, you go and live outside. You're not living, can't live in the temple like this. But the idea is everybody should work together for the service of the deity. And then everybody cooks, they make offerings for the deity, they make jewelry and so on, all offered for the deity, and they're all worshipping the one deity. Then there's real harmony there. Everybody's focus and attention is on the one deity. Not that everybody has their own deity.
Hare Krishna. Ranyaniri Phuket dekhin Shyam Prabhu ji prashna garnu bhayo Maharaj bhagwan thulthula murti ko puja garnu ra ghar ma sana vigra ko seva garnu ke antar chha bhanda kheri Maharaj le bhanu bhayo antar kehi pani chaina thula vigra ko ra sana vigra seva garnu eudai ho tara Maharaj le bhanu huncha Prabhupad le pani yo chahanu huncho sabai bhakta le vishesh gari ghar ka murti bhanda mandir ka murti lai sabai le dhyan dinu pardacha aile ke bhanta bhanda kheri pachi hamra bhakta le mandir ma basne bhakta le आफ्नो रूममै आफ्ना मूर्ति बनाए आराध्यमा तक आउन छोडे त्यसरी होइन, हामी सबैले के गर्नुपर्छ, भक्तहरू मिलेर भगवान्लाई माला बनाउने, फुल बनाउने, भगवान्को लागि सोच्ने, र त्यसै गरेर हामीले मन्दिरमा चाहिँ गर्नु पर्दछ, मन्दिरमा गरे चाहिँ उत्तम हो भनेर महाजीले भन्नुभयो।
So also another problem is you have the marriages, you know that when the marriages get contaminated, then who's going to do the puja? If you have the deity at home. When the woman's contaminated, she's not clean. She shouldn't cook for Krishna. She shouldn't touch the deities. She shouldn't do any seva. She should just rest.
जस्तै कि माताजीहरूको जो रजस्तोल भएको बेलामा मूर्तिलाई केही छुन पाइन्न, पूजा गर्न पाइन्न, पकाउन पाइन्न, र त्यसै कारण घरमा चाहिँ हो त के छ, धेरै नै समस्या छ घरमा आफै सेवा गर्दाखेरि।
So if you have the deity at home, that can be a problem, because sometimes the husband's not always available to do everything. It means the husband has to cook, the husband has to do all the puja, he has to do everything. A husband may be very busy, he doesn't like that. He's got other things to do. So we encourage everybody, you know, that have the focus, one deity. You have the one deity, one temple, and everybody's attention is there. Not that everybody has their own temple in their home, their own deities. It's not very good. All right, any other question? Yeah.
So those who already have the deity, is in some way before Jagannath ji came, we all have our own deities, Maharaj. Almost all have our deities. So what we should do?
Well, I don't know. You should bring the, maybe put the deity, put your deity in the temple. Everybody's got deities.
There's already two Gopalji and one set of Gorinda already. And not so much devotee for the service.
Yeah. Anyway, the people who give the deities, they have to come and do service at the temple.
And they are begging Vrindavan. Mahadev Vanuja, Jale Murti Mandima Raya Jatya Chai, Sadi Mandima Seva
Vanavan. You don't want to encourage any other people to get deities. You see, many people, they get the deity and then after some time they get tired. They don't want to worship and they give the deity away. It's a big responsibility to worship deities. There are three responsibilities, very heavy. One is cows, to take care of cows, very big, very difficult. Another is the deity. And the third thing is the devotees, take care of all the devotees.
मैले भने तिनवटा कुरालाई सेवा गर्न चाहिँ तिनवटा कुरालाई मिलाउन चाहिँ बहुत आपत छ एउटा चाहिँ के हो त भन्दाखेरि मूर्ति अब पहिला सुरुको गाई अरे गाईलाई पाल्न सजिलो छैन नम्बर दुई मूर्ति नम्बर तिन भक्त यी तिनवटा कुराको सेवा गर्न चाहिँ सजिलो छैन है भन्नु
Yeah, if you have a big ashram but a lot of brahmacharis, it's not easy. Take care of them all. If they're not happy, if they're not satisfied, they'll curse you. Prabhupada told all the GBC men, he said, you have to be very careful. He said, just like Yamaraj, Yamaraj got cursed. Right? You know that Yamaraj got cursed because there was one yogi, he was in a cave meditating. And some dacoits, they also came and they hid in the cave. But then the police all came, the king's men all came, and they arrested all the dacoits, and they arrested the yogi as well. They thought the yogi was with the dacoits.
What is the meaning of dacoits?
Like robber, thief.
Robber, okay. Because I take out my earphone already, so I couldn't hear nicely.
Oh, I see. So the yogi was in the cave, and these robbers, a big gang of bandits, they all came and they hid in the cave. And then the king's men, they all came and they arrested everybody, and they took the yogi as well. So they all got sentenced to death, and the yogi also was supposed to get put to death. And the way they were put to death, they would put a spear. They would put the whole body right through a spear. The metal rod would go right through the body. So just before they killed the yogi, the king found out that the yogi has been taken by mistake. So the king came and he apologized to the yogi and he said, I'm very sorry, it's a big mistake, I'm very sorry, please go, you're free. So then the yogi went to see Yamaraj. He wanted to know why this happened, why he got arrested and why they were going to kill him. And Yamaraj said, when you were a boy, you used to pierce little insects. You used to take a blade of grass and you would stick right in the insects. He said, so this was the karma. So the yogi said, I was only a little boy and you punished me like that? It's not fair. I was only a little child. I shouldn't be punished like that. So he cursed Yamaraj to become a Sudra.
Yamaraj
So Yamaraj became Vidura. So it was good for Yamaraj. It was good because he got free of all his work. You know, every day punishing all the sinful people. And he was able to go and visit. When he came as Vidura, of course he was in the palace, and then he had a big argument with Duryodhan, and then he went out. Duryodhan threw him out of the palace, and he went to visit all the holy places. So, Prabhupada warned the GBC, he said, be careful how you manage. If you make mistakes, you may get cursed like Yamaraj. So managing, being a manager, very difficult. Okay, any other question?
Okay,
one more question,
last one. Hare Krishna,
Rajasuya. Today morning I was listening class from Giridhar Maharaj from Zoom in the New Year day in the morning 9:30, and now again from your mouth, so it looks like 2021 is going to be very glorious for me. To Bhagavatam class in one morning. And I'm just a little curious, Gurudev, about the Jagannath Puri. You said new Jagannath Puri in Los Angeles. And is it still existing, or is it the same temple as New Dwarika this temple? Is it the same one now, or is it two different temples?
No. New Jagannath Puri is in San Francisco, Berkeley.
Oh, okay.
Los Angeles is New Dwarika.
Sorry, it was my mistake.
Yeah. Just beside San Francisco, they moved the San Francisco temple to Berkeley, which is just near San Francisco. So that became New Jagannath Puri.
Hare
Bol Prabhu. Do you have a question, Bhagavad Dharma?
No, Maharaj. I think they have no time. Paruji, you have no questions on the banjo? Shankunda Paru?
Hare Krishna Maharaj. So,
Arishna Paruji, question is Shana Ali Gidi.
Anusta Paruji. Sunya na?
Anya Jagi. Sunya Paru, Sunya Haru.
Maharaj, Bhagavad Dharma have one question. He is saying that Yamaraj got a punishment. Stava yara sadhu la danda mila?
Aina.
Yamaraj got a punishment because of the sadhus. So actually we should think that because of this punishment, Yamaraj got the darshan of all the pilgrims. So it should be, it is a good, right? Or we should think it's not good?
Well, for Yamaraj it was good. Yeah, it was good for Yamaraj. But, you know, still we should be careful. We don't want people cursing us.
राम्रो हो तर हामी पनि सावधान हामी चाहिँ सावधान हुनुपर्छ हामीलाई शराब चाहिँ नमिलोस् भन्नुहुन्छ
You want to try to please the devotees, get the blessings of the devotees. If you make the devotees angry, then Krishna's not pleased. But if the devotees are happy and they bless you, then Krishna's pleased. That's very good. Krishna will also give blessings. So we want to have friendly dealings with all the devotees. It's very easy for us to quarrel. That allows Kali Yuga to come in. Kali Yuga causes everybody to argue with each other and quarrel and fight. But we want to keep Kali out. We're in Krishna consciousness. We don't want Kali coming in. And so we want to have nice friendly dealings with all the devotees. No one is our enemy. This is the quality of a sadhu. One who is the real sadhu, he has no enemy. Someone may think you are his enemy, but we don't think they are our enemy. We don't have any enemy. So if we are getting arguments and quarreling and fighting, it's not spiritual. That's not the way of spiritual life. It's not the behavior of devotees. We have to always take the humble position, offer all respect to others. We don't want any respect from anybody else. We just simply want to be engaged in Krishna's service. And we see if somebody does curse us, just like Daksha cursed Narada Muni, but it was a blessing for Narada Muni. Daksha cursed Narada Muni that you will never be able to stay anywhere for any time. You have to keep moving. So Narada thought, oh, this is very good. I won't get entangled. I won't get attached to any one place. So Narada, he's a spaceman, he's always traveling here and there, everywhere. So no attachments. Okay, thank you very much. Wish everybody Happy New Year again. We hope this will be a nice year for everyone.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Maharaj.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Maharaj. So now we are going to cut the cake. Would you like to sing something for Jagannath Ji? Shortly, very short way.
Oh, really?
Some wishes. Yeah, yes. Now we are going to do last arati. So would you like to sing for that?
Sing what? Hare Krishna mantra?
Yeah, whatever. Yeah, it will be nice.
Yeah, I can try.
Okay.